Welcome back, baseball fans. Summer 69-72 carryover league. Tonight, we are in the American League North, a very troubled division. Let's just go to the standings first to explain that. So you got a super expansion team sitting at 500 in first place. Tigers clearly can make a move. The Expos are, you know, expansion team of 69, not doing much, of course. The disappointing Indians, who were seen tonight, had a horrific start of their season, even though they've been playing somewhat decent baseball. But things have changed. We are in game 6 of a best of 7 series, and it is the Indians, winners of 3 of the first 5 games. They won games 1 and games 4 and 5 on the road. The Tigers took game 2 in Cleveland and game 3 at home. But the Cleveland Indians, this is like their World Series. If they're going to go down, they're going to take their rivals with them. So this would be a devastating loss for the Tigers. The Indians have already given up the ship. It's just been a nightmare for them. But they can be vindicated today if they eliminate the Tigers 4-2 in this series. And again, just a quick look again at the at those standings. At 14-17, I don't think the Tigers are going to get anywhere close to a wild card. Their only shot would be beating up on the super expansion team to somehow get this weak division. So, yeah, we could have a team with a losing record win this division. And the Indians want to have something to do with that. Today's starting pitchers, even worse for the Tigers, their big three, their starter nines, Lolich, McClain, and Coleman, have pitched the first 5 games, which means it's Les Cain making his first and only start of the series, trying to save the Tiger season. For the Indians, Ray Washburn, acquired in the offseason trade of Jose Cardinal to the Cardinals. Let's get started from Municipal Stadium. Joe Walsh and his band of James Gangers doing a concert before the game. Tigers rearranged their lineup. Jim Northrup will now be the leadoff hitter. See if that does anything for the Tigers. 69 is the fly to left. Dick McAuliffe was batting first. These two guys flip-flopped. He lines to first. Al Kaline, 65, rolls to second. Nothing going on. Ron Davis, the right fielder against lefties, 4-11. Bouncer to first. Norm Cash is a 2-E-9 at first base and a cheap single. Chicken Stanley, 45 is a K. Ray Fosse, 2-8 off the Fosse card. Let's take a look at the Fosse card. Pre-collision, we think. 2-8 is a single to center field. And Davis will not challenge the Northrop arm. First and second, one out for hats off to Roy Foster. 69 off Kane, single to center. Davis holds at third. Base is loaded, one out. Cleveland fans are getting raucous because this is like their World Series game. It'll be Tony Horton. Here's a who. The base is loaded, one out. 612 is a walk off the Kane card. How often do you see a walk on 612 on any Strat card? But he just got one. RBI walk. One zip. Veda Pinson, very good against lefties. 62, pitcher B, and that will score a run. Runners in the corners, two outs for Buddy Bell. 65, rolls the right, flies the right. Top of two, 2-0 Tribe. Gates of Hell Brown, 1-5. Let's take a look at Gates Brown's card. I always like to show it anytime he plays. I have no idea why they let a 338 hitter have this particular card as far as where the hits are. Normally I call this the 8 card, the 8th best hitter on the team, but there you go. 1-5, a single, 1-19, a base hit. Norm Cash, 46, second X. Larry Brown is a 3, E16 at second base, and that's a double play. Willie Horton, bouncer to second, same thing, ground out. Bottom of two. Here is Larry Brown, 4-11, bouncer to first. Norm Cash again, made a big mistake in the first inning, giving up a single. makes a play here. Eddie Leon, 37. Double 1-2 is a base hit. Ron Davis, 1-8. Single dot off the Ron Davis card. Les Kane in a heap of trouble. Tiger bullpen's getting up. They cannot afford to lose this game. Runners are on the corners for Fred Stanley. They bring it up. 1-9 is ball four. He could actually break pretty soon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hits and 2 walks. You get 8 and 4 or 10 hits and you're broken. Ray Fosse, the base is loaded and 1 out. 3-12, saw the card earlier. Unfortunately, Cleveland fans, the dreaded Lomax with the bases loaded and 1 out. Hit it hard, right at somebody. Okay, top of the third. John Roseboro, 56, bounced to short. Chicken Stanley, a 3, E22, makes the play. Kevin Collins, 4-12, pitcher. Dick Trzewski, 47, single 1-3, lines out. Bottom of the third. That Lomax really helped Les Kane and the Tigers. Roy Foster, 1-9's a walk. Tony Horton, here's a who. 49, triple one, single dot. Runners on the corners, here comes the tribe again. Runners on the corners, up and hold. Veda Pinson, 3-10, right beat question mark. Foster, 14 runner, 15-16. He's got a minus 3 arm with nobody out, he's gonna hold. Still up and holding for Buddy Bell. 3-6 is center beat question mark. Now he'll run against this guy, which is Northrop. And he scores on a 14. So, selected outfielders. He got the weaker armed outfielder to run against. And we have a 3-0 game. Runner at first, 2 outs for Larry Brown. Bounce it or short. 3-0. In the 4th, Jim Northrop, 2-6 is a single. Dick McCullough, 47, is a K. Al Kaline, 2-6, double 1-2, base hit. Runners on the corners, the tie run. Gates Brown, 53, right X. This is Davis. He's a 2E16 in right field. It's all or nothing. He gets a fly ball to right, no sack fly. Norm Cash with 2 outs. 37 is a K. Bottom of 4, Eddie Leone. 49, triple 1 single. Ron Davis, 1-6 is a single to left field. Leone, a 13 runner, holds at second base. The Tigers should really consider getting this guy out of there, as he was lucky enough just to give up 3 runs. He's put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 men on in 3 innings and a couple batters. About to break, and you know what? They're gonna hook him. Tigers are playing it like it's their season. Like, this eliminates them for their entire season. First and second, nobody out in the 4th. We've seen enough of Les Kane. We're going to go to Howie Reed. Let's take a look at Howie. The Tiger bullpen could use some work because, like I mentioned, they have 3 starter 9s, Lolich, McLean, and Coleman. So they've had a lot of complete games this year, so their bullpen's relatively untested, and most of the guys are better than Les Kane. Or at least the Tigers should hope for that. So, first and second, Fred Stanley will bat against Howie Reed. The pitch, 47, off the Reed cards, a base hit in the right field. Leone will also not challenge Kaline. Bases are loaded. They're going to play back for double play here. 35, this is Fosse, single 1-6. He lines out. Now they're going to play the infield up with 1 out. For Roy Foster, 3-6 is a K. And with 2 outs, Tony Horton, 6-10, center X. Northrop is a 3 in center field, a 3-E6 in center field. Right here is your result. And he makes the catch. Oh, the Indians. Boy, what a squandering here. 3 runs. On 12 base runners. That is not very good. Top of the 5th, Willie Horton. 1-7's a K. John Roseboro, 65, center. Kevin Collins, 66, flies to right, but Washburn has put 5 goose eggs up there. 3-0 Tribe as we go to the bottom of the fifth. But first, let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Okay, bottom of the fifth. Howie Reed. Beta Pinson, 48. Single one of six is a base hit. Buddy Bell. Let's try something different. Let's do a hit and run with a C Stealer and a B hit and runner. Pop out. That didn't work. On his card, it was pop out to short. That's kind of funny. Same result. Larry Brown, 59, second C. Runner in scoring position for Eddie Leon. 56, bouncer to short. Trzuski's a 2E36 at shortstop, and he makes the play. Another runner left on base by the Indians. Making it a little difficult for Ray Washburn to finish this Tiger team off. Dick Trzuski, 43, flies it in the left. Foster, he's in left field. He's a 4E10, and he makes a two-base error. The door is cracked open. Northrop, 34, rolls to first. Runner goes to third. They're going to play back. They'll give this run up. 34. Center be question mark. McAuliffe. Trzuski has a trying to tag up as a 14 runner, 15-16. And the center fielder, Pinson's got a minus one arm. Makes it 1-15 to cut it to one run. And he's thrown out on an 18 by Veda Pinson. Great throw. That will be a 8-8-2 double play. Wow. Tiger season is really in trouble. 3-0. Bottom of the sixth. Howie Reed. I'll give you a third inning if you can. Ron Davis, 54, pops to short. Fred Stanley, 59, second X. This is McAuliffe at 2E22. Makes the play. Fosse, 210 single. Roy Foster, 39, bounced to short. Three good innings. In relief for Howie Reed, keeping the Tigers in it. Washburn in the seventh inning. The Indians should start thinking, if there is defense to bring in, do it. The only defense would be Dave Marshall to play left field for Roy Foster, who just batted. He'll do that. Chris Chambliss to play first base for Eddie Leon in the ninth spot. And there you go. So Cleveland now, 9 outs away from a 3-0 victory and a series win. And Ray Washburn with a very good bullpen, Eddie Watt, Steve Mingori. Can the Tribe close the Tigers out? It'll be K-Line leading off the seventh. 64, catcher's card. This is Fosse. He's a one. He's out. Gates Brown, 56, bouncer to short. Chicken Stanley, a 3-22, but he makes a base hit there. Not good. Norm Cash, 59, off the Washburn card. Triple, 1-5, single dot dot. You got runners on the corners. He's throwing a shutout, folks. You don't want him to lose. He's got two men on. He can pitch to Willie Horton here. Runners on the corners. Willie Horton with one out, looking for a double play ball. The pitch to Willie. 1-6 is a ground ball short, a plus. That's a double play ball because they're not holding the East Steeler Norm Cash at first base. Short, a plus. The Tigers have no speed whatsoever on this team, and that is, they're terrible. Gates Brown, oddly enough, is a C Steeler. He's the best guy they have. Even Mickey Stanley is an E Steeler, which is odd. So that's a 6-4-3 double play for the Tigers. Their season is on the brink before we get to the All-Star break. And it's stretch time in Cleveland. It's all the same here. The Thirds LP by the James Gang, 1971. Third great LP in a row with Joe Walsh. Bottom of the seventh. Howie Reed comes out. We're going to go Keeley in the seventh. The righty seems to be doing pretty well. Steve Keeley, if things get ugly, they can go to Hiller to try and save their season. Right now, Steve Keeley will pitch to the DH, Tony Horton. 63, bounces the first. Vita Pinson. 3-6, skies the center field. And with two outs, Buddy Bell. 69, triple, 1-3, doubles a double. Larry Brown with a runner, second and two outs. 46 is a walk. And it's Chambliss in the nine hole. And you know what? We're not taking any chances. The Tigers are still... I mean, we're down to the lowest percentile you can imagine of saving the season now. Two on, two outs in the seventh against the Indians, and it's John Hiller in the eighth inning who would pitch. If the Tigers come back and win this game, he would just finish this game. He's a relief three, starter six. So Hiller comes in with first and second and two outs to face the lefty Chris Chambliss. Let's take a look at Chambliss's car. This was his rookie year of 71. The pitch to Chris Chambliss. 1-8 is a K. Tigers are just trying. They're still clinging to a threat of a chance of winning this thing. It's 3-0. Washburn's still in there. You got lefty, lefty, righty. Lefty, lefty. I'm thinking, Washburn's good against lefties, and again, you have to, break him to get him out of there with two base runners. They have Mingori and Watts. Mingori had a two-inning save in Game 5, so I don't want him to go for two innings today. I'd rather have Mingori just pitch a single inning. So it's up to Washburn and Eddie Watt and Denny Riddleberger to somehow get through the eighth for the Indians. Leading off is John Roseborough. 37, bounces the second. Kevin Collins. 64, catcher's card, it's Fosse, you're out. And with two outs, Dick Trzuski. Gosh, you got to try a pinch hitter here. Trzuski hit .139. My goodness. So Maddox, Elliot Maddox will pinch hit for him. At least he hit .248. Elliot Maddox with two outs here. 5-10, he gets the column and the card. He's got power. It's homer 1-7 off Washburn. He gets a double. So that's a double for Maddox. And now you have Northrop and McAuliffe. And I think it's an opportunity to get Washburn out after 7 2/3, needing only four outs. The theory is you have Riddleberger, can get lefties out as well, and you got Watt, and then you can have Mingori. Those three relievers can certainly get four batters out. So Denny Riddleberger, let's take a look at this guy, lefty specialist, will face Northrop and McAuliffe in the eighth inning if necessary. Riddleberger in the eighth. It's a 3-0 game with a runner at second and two outs. Jim Northrop, let's look at Northrop's card. Great year for Northrop in 69. Here's the pitch to Jim Northrop. 3-6 against the lefties, a walk. And so it will be McAuliffe, the tie run. Tigers will bring a tie run to the plate in the eighth inning. Two on, two outs. Dick McAuliffe. 64 off of Riddleberger is a K. A big strikeout. We go to the bottom of the eighth inning. Hiller against Ron Davis. 44. 4-4 off Hiller would have been a homer if he had power. He's not. It's a single. Fred Stanley, not a good bunter. He will hit away. 59, second X. This is McAuliffe at 2E22. That's double play ball. And with two outs, it's Ray Fosse. And that's a strikeout. So here we go, folks. Ninth inning, a 3-0 game. And you got a righty, K-line. So we'll take Riddleberger out. We got Eddie Watt and Mingori to try and combine for three outs with a three-run lead to ruin the Tiger season and make the Indian fans happy, because it's been a rough ride this year. So Al Kaline leading off the ninth. 111 flies to right. Gates Brown, 56, bounces to second. Second baseman Larry Brown's a 3E16, and he makes the play. And it's all up to Norm Cash. 38's a walk. And it's all up to Willie Horton. 66 is a pop to first base. The shutout is completed by the bullpen. The Indians have won this series 4-2. Break up the Indians. It's been a horrible year for them. They're not going anywhere, but the Tigers aren't either. Eddie Watt gets the save, walks the guy in the ninth. Riddleberger, a walk and a K in the eighth. 7 2/3 incredibly strong innings for Ray Washburn. 6 hits, no walks and 3 strikeouts. Hiller came on in the eighth, did what he needed to do, got a hit and 2 strikeouts. Keeley gave up a hit and a walk. Really good middle relief by Howie Reed. Kept the game alive at least, giving up just 2 hits and a K in 3 innings. It really was number 4 starter Les Kane was overmatched. Doesn't pitch very often for this team. Gave up 9 hits and 3 runs. Could have been a lot worse than that. Walked 3 and struck out 1. Your box is 1019, 0108, 313, 06, 2444. So the Tigers only put 8 men on. The Indians put 17 men on. They deserve to win that game. And actually, one of Detroit's wins. The Indians should have won that one. So very, I could have seen the Indians winning 5 of these 6 games. 1019, 0108, 313, 06, 2444. No idea what's going to happen in this division. Do the Ohio players do the unthinkable and win the division? Well, if you watched last year, you saw the Colorado Rockies, an expansion team, well, a fictional team because, of course, it's 1969, win their division. But again, that division is all expansion teams, so you're going to get one into the playoffs every year. To get the Ohio players to win a division, which Cleveland and Detroit should win handily, would be a shocker. And it looks like we're on par for that. Tigers, 14-17, hitting .253, team ERA of 4. Both those numbers are not good, not when you have that good of starting pitching and a great Tiger offense. For the Indians, the 10-18 Indians, yeah, they're not going to get to 500 this year. They're not going to get into the playoffs. They'll be knocked out in the first round of the tournament. In the postseason tournament, they are hitting .262, a .452 ERA. And if you're wondering how it all went wrong for the Indians, their ace, Gaylord Perry, he of the 1.92 ERA in 1972. Gaylord Perry is 1-7 with an ERA of .450. The Indians and Giants had a blockbuster trade in the offseason. It was Gaylord Perry, Mike McCormick, and Dave Marshall for Sam McDowell and some draft tokens and whatnot. And Sam McDowell's been pretty good for the Giants, but Gaylord Perry's been awful for the Indians. Anyway, we have now played 393 games this year. We're hitting .260 with a .387 league ERA. Thanks for checking out the video. We'll see you next time.